So guys, this is the plan for today. All of those things, as you see on the map, everything is really close by. They got at least 5 minutes different, so possibly I will be finishing by 6 max and catch my train, go to the airport and go back to UK. So let's see how the day goes. I'm now here at the first attraction of the day, Saint Sofia statue that took the place in 2000 of Vladimir Lenin statue. And here it is. Her name, Sofia, means wisdom in Greek. So there is an owl on her right side that also means wisdom. And on her left side, I'm not sure how it's called in English, but it means success, reputation. So it's a big statue. So now we're continuing, as you see behind me, to Sveta Nedelya church. In front of me we got the Sveta Nedelya church, St. George church, a medieval one that gone through many destructions and got reconstructed. So I will go around, see if I can get a better angle for you, but at night this looks amazing. And right next to the Sveta Nedelya church, you got the oldest architectural monument in Sofia, that is St.George Rotunda. And in the pictures it was looking way more smaller, but it's big. And also you got some Roman ruins right in front of it. So I just went inside the church, but I didn't want to vlog because it shows disrespect. And right here through the glass you can see the guards from the presidency. If you got time and you want to see the changing guards, go ahead. I came to a metro station and they got like a museum. Few minutes you reach to all of the attractions. You can do it in any order. If you follow my plan, it will save you time. Behind me there are the ruins in Serdica metro station. And in front of me you got Banya Bashi Mosque that I will be going later on. And next to it is the place that we are heading to, that is the Regional History Museum. So this is a modern history museum that was once used as a public bath. It's a nice building, got a nice architecture, and people come here feeling the waters. I'm not sure how healthy is that, but if people do that, it's pretty fine. Look at this guy, it says here, no bathing, washing up or washing. This is what I was telling you about. And it's really hot, really nice. And we'll give it a try and see how it tastes. That wasn't bad actually. And now we'll be going around the Banya Bashi Mosque, the one that we passed before. Banya Bashi means many baths and was built over a natural thermal spa. And also it's the only mosque in Sofia. Right next to me it's Sofia Synagogue, the largest in Southeastern Europe and also the third largest in Europe. So we arrive now to the ladies market, also known as Zensky Bazaar. The market just opening now, they are setting out their counters. So why waste time and not visit some other attraction? We'll be going to the Lion's Bridge, that is 7 minutes from here. And this is the Lion's Bridge with four huge statues of lions sitting on the bridge. There's nothing else to see here, or that I'm aware of. And now I'm back at the market. I will be entering on the other side. And it's now 9:30. And it took me, what, 1.5 hours so far, all of the attractions. So you could do it even less, because I was vlogging, I was taking pictures, taking my time. So yeah, I think the market opens fully at 10 o'clock because it's crowded. I want to be safe and also be safe for the other people around me. I will be wearing the mask, so So I'm not sure if you will be able to hear me probably. Guys, I will not be filming the market inside. It's not allowed because of the COVID. I don't know why, but we must respect the rules. So my plan is I will spend maybe 9-10 leva and see what we can get with 5 euros. And yeah, basically that's the market. It stretches up, goes all the way. So I will go around, get some stuff, and I will show you when I finish from here. Just finished from the market. I wasn't able to spend 10 and 11. Look at all of this. This is some oranges. It was 1 leva, bananas, 1 leva, carrot, and some grapes, apples. All of those was about 5 to 6 leva. That's 250 euros. It's really, really cheap, and that's why it's considered one of the cheapest countries in Europe. I just split them in between with grapes, apples, oranges, bananas. So I will be going around giving one bag of each homeless I find. Here you go, some fruits. And this is the National Art Museum. It used to be the residency of the governor during the occupation of the Ottoman, but now it's a National Art Museum that holds 50,000 pieces of art. So I'm making my way to the most famous attraction, Sofia, that is the Cathedral of Alexander Nevsky. That is exactly there on the back. I'm passing through a few things that I wanted to show you. And this is a Russian church called Sveta. And before we reach to that cathedral, I will also show you some other stuff and then reach to our destination. I'm now passing through Ivan Vazov monument. Here it is. Ivan Vazov was a Bulgarian poet. Right next to this monument is Saint Sofia Church. About this church is the oldest church in Sofia, and also this church is where the name was given to the capital of Bulgaria, that is called Sofia. And here it is, one of the most main attractions of Sofia and the most important Orthodox church in Bulgaria. But I will tell you more details about it when we get a better angle. Angle of this cathedral to give you some facts about it. The Bulgarian people wanted to build a monument about the Bulgarians and Russians that fought and died for the liberation of Bulgaria. And also the name of the cathedral was from a prince at 13th century that became a saint who engaged and fought in many hard battles. Also on the top there, it's pure gold, the dome. And yeah, this is more impressive in person than in the pictures. A really big church and such an amazing structure. Is the roof bar open?
Yes, so straight to the right.
Okay. Do I need a reservation or no?
No.
Okay, thank you. And now I came to this roof bar called Sense Hotel. It's really nice, look at this view. And also, if you come to Bulgaria, you must try a ragia. I will try that later. Got a fresh juice and also I'm waiting now for a shoshka salad. That also is a recommendation while you are in Sofia. This is what I call food with a view. Nice, fresh, and the Bulgarian cheese is amazing. So I'll finish this and then we go on rakia.
And now it's time to try our rakia. We got our juice for Quagap. But it smells like Zivania, similar thing we got in Cyprus. This is 40% alcohol and usually may go even 90 if it's homemade. And it's been made, this one, from grapes. And also you can find it with different fruits. So a famous one would be grape or rose. So let's give it a try.
Well, that rakia was strong. Now I'm making my way to the National Theater of Ivan Vazov. It's only 5 minutes from the hotel. And from there, I believe I will go to Vitosha Boulevard, have some more food, some more drink. I have no idea what you're talking about. And from there, possibly I will go get my bike and go back to the airport and back to UK. And that one behind me is Ivan Vazov National Theatre. From here, I believe I will go to Vitosha Boulevard, as I said, and get some more food, drink some wine, get some souvenirs, and end the day there. And this is the Vitosha Boulevard, the one that we finished the day yesterday. And finished shopping from the Vitosha Boulevard, got my souvenirs. I spent, I think, 80 with 100 leva, so that's 50 euros. But I will show all of the souvenirs later on when I go to the airport and tell you more about the prices. So now I will just find a place to sit. I've got another 2 hours to catch the train. So sat here in Vitosha Boulevard to a restaurant. Just got the taratori soup with a crepe and shumesko beer. I don't know how it will combine with these things, but they didn't have any wine that I wanted to try or some other things, local dishes, but that's fine. I'll give it a try and see how that goes. I'm 100% it has yogurt and cucumbers, so it's a cold soup with yogurt, cucumbers, and I don't know what else, but it's a local thing that you must try if you are in Bulgaria. And it tastes nice, it's refreshing. Let's give it a try of this local beer and see. I believe it should be similar to all of the beers, but yes, it's just a beer.
Next station, Sofia Airport.
And as I promised, I will be showing you the souvenirs and how much each one cost. So the cup placemat costs 3 leva and has 6 in it. The tablecloth that is handmade costs 3 leva. The keyring, 3 leva. The magnets, 150 each. And the cup was 10 leva. About this, I cannot tell because they are for presents. The total cost of all the souvenirs was 83 leva. So here it's where we'll end the vlog. I had a great time in Bulgaria, really friendly people. I really enjoyed myself. My total cost of everything, including accommodation and flights, was about £200. So that's really cheap for a holiday. Just £200 for everything. So I hope you guys got some information about it. Don't forget to subscribe, comment, and like the video. And until next time, have a great one. See you.